will grab a space, stand up for me, so we can bow into class. Perfect. Let's see. Make sure we're, there we go. All right. So guys, mute your camera for me. Perfect. And we'll get started. Man, thank you guys so much for training. It means a lot to us to see you here on your Wednesday night. I would like to run through a whole lot of the jiu-jitsu we've been working on and then add in a new avenue for the truck, right? So we're going to keep the truck going, but we're going to look at it from a little different style guard pass, right? One we got to be a little bit careful with when we get back into the schools, but, you know, we'll get there. And as you guys heard with the announcement yesterday, there wasn't a whole lot changed that, like, in our realm, but there's still the window of opportunity for us in a few different ways, and we're looking at even going so far as looking for, like, even small groups that will be able to work in the school. We're exploring every avenue we can. So, guys, just know that as soon as we can, like, we will be announcing some ways to get us back on the mats in any capacity whatsoever at this point, right? So just eyes up, ready for the email. You'll see it. Before that, though, I want to keep working on our back attacks. Let's bow in and warm up. We'll hit the floor. Perfect. All right. Let's see. Coach Jordan, you got all this, buddy? Perfect.
Yeah, we're good.
Awesome. So, guys, we'll get on the mat. I need 30 seconds. We'll go break falls. Nothing too fast. And war time. Dude, she hates break falls.
How does she even know?
She got sense of, she got spidey senses for break falls. 10 seconds here, guys. Nice, easy pace. Let's get that back loose.
Jules, no.
I'm going to ask for a little bit of mobility in today's class. And we'll switch to triangles. Hips to the sky. Remember, we're shooting our triangle, which means your low back cannot be on the floor. This is that time to practice. Nice. 10 seconds. And then we'll switch to our Kimuras. Watch out for your partner, no headbutts. Perfect.
I ate too many Oreos. I'm like, right for
it. Yeah. It doesn't quite feel the same free quarantine. 3, 2, 1. Nice. We'll go with our bridges. Remember, let's open up the instep on the direction that you're bridging. Feel the difference in how it opens up that hip. Really important when we're talking about bridging and shrimping out of side control. It's 10 seconds. And shrimping. Remember, a little bit of a bridge to that shrimp. Let's try to get all the way on our side, newbies. And maybe purple belts who are taking the warm-up nice and slow. I understand this might be the first warm-up you've had as a purple belt in a while. Take your time.
I want to do the old time.
breathe it out. You'll be okay, upper belts.
Like a wolf.
And last one. Turtle up. Sit outs. Remember, not too fast. Just don't stop. And work time. Trying to look up at the ceiling to finish that rep. Keep that neck strong. Ten seconds. Five. Four.
Long 10 seconds.
Three. Two. One. Whew. Nice work. All right, guys. See now how this goes. Beth and I will run through the rep. We'll all run through the rep. And then Beth will be running a rep on the stuffy buddy while I watch you. I say all that because I want to add our leg weave to the end of the warm-up that we were using the last week. That was Toriando and leg drag. So I want to warm up with three guard passes that have a gang of movement in them. For my friends that are new to class, find a stopping point that feels really comfortable and just keep drilling there. Everybody, a whole lot of these faces I've seen this whole time in Zoom. So I know you know this, which is why I feel comfortable having this chain be really long. All right? So the first one, the Toriando, you know it. It's going to have the hop over. In case our partner tries to defend, double pants grips, back up, feet to floor, shuffle to the left. Left knee down, left shoulder down. Partner pushes our head to the floor. Left hand down, headstand up on our toes. Hop over to the other side. Now, if you have a stuffy buddy, we'll just stand up. If you have a partner, frame, bridge, shrimp. Switch our feet, and now we'll be able to go again. We'll come back. Perfect. This time we'll go leg drag. The double pants grips, your right hand will go to the hip. Left hand's gonna stay on the knee. Shuffle to the left. And now when you shuffle to the right, push that knee past your right elbow. Landing in the leg drag. From here, we're gonna take our hands, push our partner's hands to their belly. Straighten our left leg. Don't kick their face off. When my left heel hits my right knee, now I can go underhook. Baseball slide my left hip to the floor, pulling my partner's arm up with me, ending up in modified case katami. We're still going. Stuff the hand to the face. Step over to north-south. Move that right elbow. Back step, case katami the other side. From here, if I have a stuffy buddy, I just stand up. If I have a partner, they'll re-guard. Then we'll stand up. And last one, the newest pass we've been working on, headquarters to leg weave. Bring this way a little bit. So remember, we'll step up a foot in the middle, a foot to the outside. Left hand pants grip, right hand collar grip. Sitting on the foot, but our left knee hamstring to the back of the leg. Shuffle to the right so your left knee can fall in the hole. You're gonna go left hand underhook, right hand cross face, step up that right foot. Let's go to the mount, okay? So no truck, we're just warming up. Take it easy. Let's go to the mount instead. Right hand elbow grip, right knee in the armpit. Go back to the cross face. Left hand walks their arm over their head. Left leg steps over the hip, putting us into the mount. From here, senior student, since you'll be going first, finish with any attack you like. Collar jokes, etc. I just wanted to see it sub from the mount. All right. So, should feel really familiar, right? Senior student, stand up for me. Junior student, lay down. And let's do this whole rep together. All right, starts with the Toreando. Double pants grips, beat the floor, shuffle to the left. Left knee down, left shoulder down. Partner pushes your head. Left hand post, forehead post, get up on your toes. Walk to the right. Side control on the other side. Now our partner is gonna re-guard, or if you have a stuffy buddy, just stand up. Now let's go leg drag. Right hand to the hip, left hand pants grip, walk to the left. As you walk to the right, push that pants grip to the right. Staple your right knee in between your partner's legs. Both of their legs should be on our right side. From here, we're gonna take our partner's hands, pin them to their chest. Straighten our left leg, walk it over the head. Now my left hand can go under hook. My right hand is gonna pull up on the near sleeve, and I'm gonna baseball slide down the hip into case katana. From here, we'll stuff their hand to their face, bring our right leg over, move to north-south. From north-south, we'll move our right elbow across the hip, back step, case katana on the other side. My partner will re-guard, or I will just stand up if they have a stuffy body. And now let's go headquarters. Step a foot, right foot in the middle, left hand pants grip, left knee in the back of the hammy, right hand collar grip. You're kind of sat up, pulling up on that collar grip. Shuffle to the right, left leg staples their bottom leg. My left hand gets an underhook, my right hand gets a cross face, and my right leg steps up. My right hand will pull up on the elbow, so my right knee can go in the armpit. Right hand will cross face. Left underhook will start to walk their arm over their face, so our left knee can step over to the mount. From here, any submission you want, upper belt. That arm bar is pretty close. Up to you though. Word time, unless we got questions. Everybody feel good with that? Can I get a thumbs up if you feel good? Yeah, anybody have questions? All right, senior student, you're running this whole round. Lots of passes, take your time. Let's clap it out on three. Ready, one, two. Work time. Starts off with the Toreando. Remember, if you get lost, we'll just look up and follow Beth. So no pressure, purple belt. There's a hop over on that Toreando pass, and then your partner will re-guard, or you'll just stand up. Now we'll go for the leg drag. Right hand to the hip, we'll walk to the left. As we walk back to the right, we'll stuff that knee. Leg drag. We'll pin their hands to their chest so we can high step our left leg over their face. Left hand underhook, right hand overhook. Baseball slide to case katana. We'll push their hand to their face, step over their head for north-south. Right hand will move across the hip, we'll back step our left foot, case katana on the other side, modified case katana. From here, our partner will re-guard or we'll stand up for our third and final pass, headquarters. From headquarters, we're gonna shuffle to the right and hit the leg weave. Our left hand's gonna underhook, our right hand's gonna cross face, and our right foot's gonna step up. From here, our right hand will pummel the inside frame, pulling that elbow off the floor. I really wanna get it high, so our right knee can slide up into the armpit. From here, our right hand will go back to cross face, and our left hand will start walking that underhook high, like you're gonna try to walk their arm over their face. Your left knee will simultaneously be sliding up into the mount. From here, upper belt, finish however you like. Chokes, arm bars, maybe you're fancy and got some cool triangle set up. I'm down. Hop up, run the whole series again, all three passes with the variations. All the jiu-jitsu at once. Nice. Coach E's doggy is helping.
I'm sure she's being very helpful. My assistant fell asleep.
Sanjay, good to see you, bro. I mean, I can't see you, but I'm imagining your face with your name.
Hey,
how's it going? And now your voice.
I'm chilling here with Tim right now, actually.
Hey, what's up, Tim? How you feeling, buddy?
Yeah, feeling good. Gonna get moving around some.
Yeah, you guys feel good with this? This is a lot. You feel okay?
Beautiful stuff. Yeah, feeling good, awesome. Yeah.
Perfect, perfect. Get back to work. I see you slacking, purple belt. Nice. There we go, John. Yep. We'll find north, south. Perfect. Nice, Thomas. Yes. We'll start our leg weave. Perfect. Underhook, overhook. Slide that right knee high into the armpit so that left leg can step over the hips, and we'll make our way to the mount. Nice. There you go, John. Left hand walks high, left leg steps over. Mount, finish however you feel, blue belt. Dealer's choice, just make sure we finish. Nice, Josh, very nice. Good work, my friends, you're doing great. Three of the major passes you're gonna play in today's jiu-jitsu. Three of my personal favorite passes. If I was gonna be biased, these are absolutely my more higher percentage passes. And one more, which we're about to learn. From the standing zone. Nice, Quan. Super sticky, buddy. Yes. Remember, guys, if you have a group of three, let's just go one for one. So nobody has to sit out too long. Perfect. Nice, Brayden. Very nice, buddy. Good work, Ben. Super high. If you know the head and arm triangle, it's a nice time to attack it coming off of the leg weave. It'll lead to a lot of Ezekiels, that sneaky Ezekiel we've been working a little bit. Good work. Give me 10 more seconds. Try to finish the series you're on. If you're started, try to get all three. No time to pause. No reason to stop and admire your work. Keep moving. Very nice. Just like your jiu-jitsu match, my friends. You can't stop and watch. Everything changes. Good work. Nice pace. And time, very nice. All right, so let's flip flop. If you have a partner, we're gonna switch bottom to top. If you have a stuffy buddy, here's your chance to catch your breath or to run another rep with us, okay? So junior student, you hop up, you will be running this technique with Beth. All right, junior student, it starts with our Toriando, two pants grips. Put the feet to the floor, shuffle to the left knee down, left shoulder down. Your senior student partner is gonna scoop up your head and push it to the same side as your legs. So you're gonna post your left hand and your forehead, and you're gonna get on your toes. You're gonna walk over the legs that you were hugging with your right arm. Now from here, if you have a partner, they're gonna re-guard. If you have a stuffy buddy, just stand up, pretend they hit the re-guard. And now we're on to the second pass. Right hand hip grip, left hand knee grip, and we're going to shuffle to the left. Notice how Beth got perpendicular to me, right? She didn't stop. Can we rewind just a little bit? She didn't stop right here just because she got my knee to the floor. If she stops right here, my leg is still going to catch her belly if she tries to run to the right. She's got to get perpendicular to where now my feet aren't even facing her. This is the only way we'll get this leg drag to work, guys. We have to have the best angle we can, right? The most skillful angle here. So as Beth runs to the right, she's going to pick up the pants. Leg drag. Your right knee should staple their bottom thigh. You should have both their legs on your right side. From here, you're going to push both their hands to their chest. Whoa, she's really fast. Rewind, please. Hands to chest. You're going to straighten out your left leg. Be really careful. Please don't kick their face off. Get it over their head. Then notice, as you curl that leg, you're going to start bringing your left hand underhook, your right hand elbow grip, and you're going to baseball slide to the floor. So in this modified case katami position, you're going to take that right hand and push their arm over their face. So your right knee can step over the head for north-south. Now your right elbow will go over the hip. Your left leg will back step, and you end up in modified case katami on the other side. From here, we're going to re-guard or just stand up like they re-guard. Move to our third and final pass, headquarters. From headquarters, you have a left hand grip on the knee, a right hand grip on the collar. Your right foot steps in between your partner's legs. Your left foot goes knee to the back of their hammy. It's kind of uncomfortable. Use it like a wedge so you can pick up on the collar grip. And it compresses the guard. It doesn't work anymore. Now, your right foot's going to go first. The left leg's going to go with it. Start walking to the right. As you walk to the right, you're going to stretch out their bottom leg. Your left hand's going to underhook. Your right hand's going to cross face. And your right foot's going to step up so you can be stable. From here, your right hand will go scoop up the elbow. Pick it up off the floor really high because your right knee's going to go into the armpit. Now, you're going to go back to the cross face of that right hand, and your knee kind of holds their elbow in place. Your left hand is going to start walking their right arm over their face so your left leg can step over the hips into the mount. Now, junior student, finish however you like here in the mount. She's got some fancy stuff, but it can be as easy as a cross-collar choke. It's a great thing to practice in this position. From here, we'll be done. We'll hop up. We'll run the whole series again. If you get lost, we'll just watch Beth. She's running that thing as well. Thumbs up, junior students. You feel good? Does anyone have questions? All right, let's go on three. You ready? One, two. Work time. As it starts the Toriando pass, my friends. We're shuffling to the left. We're long darting our left shoulder. From there, we'll hop over because they're going to push our head to the same side as our legs. We'll hop over to side control on the other side. From there, they'll re-guard or we'll just stand up and we'll start our second pass, the leg drag. Hip grip, knee grip, shuffle to the left, shuffle to the right, staple their leg down. You're gonna pin their hands to their chest. High step your leg over the face. Slide it to the mat. Your right hand's gonna go, no, don't listen. Your left hand's gonna go underhook. Your right hand's an overhook and you're gonna baseball slide to the mat. Very nice. From here, we're gonna push their hand to their face, step over their head, north-south. From north-south, we'll move our right elbow over the hip. Backstep our left leg and end up in that same modified case katami just on the other side. Our partner will re-guard and we'll start our third pass. Let's get to headquarters. Right foot in the middle, left kneecap behind their hamstring, left hand pants grip, right hand collar grip. Perfect. From here, we're going to start to shuffle to the right, stretching out their bottom leg and bringing their top leg with us so we can staple our left knee to the inside thigh. From here, Beth's looking to get a left hand underhook, a right hand cross face, and she'll do that by stepping up her right foot. Once she's connected, her right hand will scoop up the elbow really, really high so her right knee can go straight into the armpit. Now her right hand will go back to the cross face. Your legs is going to hold on to that elbow. You'll be fine. Your left hand's going to start walking the underhook high. Like you're going to try to pass their arm over their face because your left knee is going to slide over the hips and into the mount. From here, finish whatever you like, my friends. You're in the mount. It's a great spot to be. Whatever you're drilling, cross chokes, arm bars, Ezekiels, triangles with our arms and our legs. Oh my goodness. So many options. Nice work. There we go, Wendy. Perfect. Nice. Watch out for the furniture. Don't get the family mad when we kick over the living room. Your pets will be super upset. Nice, Quan. Here comes our high step. Hey, underhook. Perfect. Nice, Rich. Very nice, buddy. Hey, how much that headstand has improved in your guard pass, bro. That's impressive. Nice. There we go, Jay. Very nice. Get that tap on pops every rep, buddy. You got about a minute left, junior students. I know it's a long chain, but you know this. And this is how we're going to start passing those upper belt guards. We're going to have multiple passes that we're going to throw at once. It just becomes this infinite chain that you can just keep cycling through until the guard breaks down. I promise, the guard is built to run slower than the guard pass. So if you can keep moving with your guard passes, the guard is slowly degrading as that process extends out. So having the ability to chain together multiple passes is vital when we're talking about passing the guard. Especially when we're trying to pass the black belt guard that you've been thinking about, the one in your dreams, right? Nice. 30 seconds. Should be able to get through the whole chain in that time. Just won't be able to stop and watch. Keep breathing, try not to hold our breath. Whew. Very nice. You're halfway. Good work, good work. Notice how the smoothness is allowing you to pick up your pace. Starts to fit together. Sanding off some of these rough edges. And time. Good work. Whew. Nice job. I think it's really easy for us to get stuck on like the things that we struggle with, the things that feel difficult, or it's just built into us a little bit to notice the things that are hard for us. I don't know if a lot of us are programmed to think about the ways that, like, even when it was hard, you worked your ass off and you made it to where it was easier for you, right? It never changed. That whole chain that we've been building block by block by block for weeks now, going on over 2 months, that has been the same level of difficulty the whole time, right? We've been talking about advanced class this whole time. You've changed. You've put in tremendous work to where our warm-up for the class, our flow for the class, could be three distinct guard passes that are intricately tied together with variations that you can do as a part of the whole chain, right? Not a, ooh, I know when it happens, when I get here, I do this. You can cycle through an entire system now with your guard passing. I just think, like, it'd be nice of you to acknowledge that to yourself, right? Like, man, I worked really hard, and I can do some pretty cool systems now with my guard passing that maybe I couldn't do before. Just acknowledge that a little bit, right? Congratulations, man. You worked your ass off, and it's obvious because I got to watch an incredible flow with everybody training tonight. That was awesome. Now, I would like to go to something a little abstract. We're going to have the guard pass, but we're going to do one that we don't traditionally see in the school. You see it a lot in competition, but we don't see it in the school too much because we want to be nice to our partners. We need to be careful with our partners. So we're going to go to a true stack. And when we stack, we've got to be really careful with our partner's neck. I don't want to jam Beth's knees to her shoulders because then I could really hurt her spine, okay? So this particular pass, you got to be very careful with. And we're not going to try to compress them. Instead, we're going to get two heel grips. So we've been playing the open guard with these pants grips at the knees, hips, and collars. Now we're going to go from the pants. We're going to roll our hands underneath and get two calf grips. From here, we're going to start pushing our palms forward. And our hands won't be strong enough, right? So when we actually do this, I go from the knee grips. She's going to try to put her feet on my biceps. I'm going to roll my hands underneath for the calf grips. And as I push my hands forward, my knees are going to come with me. They're going to go shins right behind the hips to help hold her up just for a second. Because I want to change my grips from palms to heels. Now, with the heel grips, I'm going to pick a side. So for the camera, I'm going to pick the right side. I'm going to start to stack and pass her legs off to that right side. Because my right foot is going to step as I sit down. As we go, my right hand is going to switch to the other leg. I'm going to post, slide my hip underneath. Notice how my hips are still facing Beth. I'm not flat on my back yet because my left foot, the twister hook, is not in yet. Curl that left leg. It's got to be on the femur, which means that when you sat down, you need to stay on your side so you can keep their hips up. So your left leg can curl the femur, and now I can put on the lockdown. I'll take that right leg, bite my left ankle, put my right ankle behind my partner's Achilles heel, and we're ready to rock and roll. Remember, you might attack truck now in the banana split, or you might let go of the leg completely, extend the truck, extend the lockdown, underhook the arm with your right hand, scoop up the neck with your left hand, and we made our way to the back. So, again, we're kind of building on the knowledge that you've been working on the last couple months. Very, very advanced back attack here. You're gonna have to be very careful with your partners, and when you do it with your gi dummy, this is one of the times the gi dummy action is probably better for if this is your first time ever, because we're gonna need to practice stretching out our partner's leg, and when we do it in real life, it can get very uncomfortable for our partner. So if you have a partner in tonight's class and you've never done this before, please go slow. Talk to your partner. They'll be able to tell you when they're like this and stretched out. Some spots are going to be too uncomfortable. We can't hold them there. Work with your partner. Let them be a little bit comfortable as we get the fit in. All right? So I'm going to show Beth one more time, and then we're going to do one together, okay? So let's see it again. Let's see it from a little different angle. Let's get way back. All right, so when we approach the open guard, when we grab the knees, the answer for the guard player will always be to go to the biceps. Because now she can start establishing a collar and sleeve or a spider guard. So before that happens, the moment I feel feet roll inside, I have a chance. Take my hands, roll them underneath the double calf grips, push my hands forward by keeping my elbows closed. They're on my hips. So as I walk forward, they can help me push on the legs. Now, with my knees behind the hips, just to hold her up for a second so I can let go of the calves and move to the heels. I'm going to take the heel grips, guys, and I'm going to start pushing them down. Stacking my partner up. Now, as I do that, we're going to shuffle to the right just a bit So my left knee is still behind Beth's hips because I don't want her to fall back into guard. So I'm keeping her up on her neck. My right hand's gonna switch to the other leg. So is my left hand. My left hand's gonna go to the floor. My right foot is gonna step on the calf as I slide to my left hip. Remember, don't fall back. Stay hips forward so your left knee can curl onto the femur. Now my right leg can curl around the twister hook, putting in the lockdown. From here, I can fall to my back, into the banana split, the truck, whatever we need. Or I let go, hook the arm, hook the neck, and we're on to all our back attack series.
Oh, thank God. I was having a fat roll, was cramping.
All right, so you hear from the purple belt. It's not a super comfortable position. You got to be very careful with your partner, especially if you have a lot smaller partner. I may advocate not even putting your foot on the heel of the small partner. We'll show it on this rep. We just got to make sure we don't crunch nobody up as we learn this one. This is one of those times where it helps to let go of the idea of up and down in jiu-jitsu. Because it feels like, oh my goodness, I just laid down. Like, this person's going to stand up now. Like, what kind of jiu-jitsu is this? But if we can keep the idea that getting behind their knees is almost always a free pass through the guard and to the back, then this doesn't feel like such an odd movement, right? It doesn't seem counterintuitive at all if I can get behind the legs. If I can get behind the knees, I'm gonna get to the back. So I'm down to try some craziness, all right? Let's try it out. First, we're in the same position we've always been. Hands grips. Our partner's gonna roll their feet to our biceps. So we take our hands and roll inside, palms to the back of the calves. Now, if you're having a hard time with that, if your partner feels too strong, roll your hands one more time. So from palms up, I'll turn them in to where I get C-clamp grips right on the hamstrings. And that will do the same thing for me. But I don't like that one quite as much because you'll notice it compresses her. And now it's harder to get under her hips to lift her. So I recommend staying with the palms up grip, pushing on the top of the calves so you can pick up the hips with your legs, walk them up. Now my knees will hold her in this inverted position and she's still gonna be trying to play guard, guys. She's gonna be trying to get the spider guard. You gotta be really careful here. Don't get triangle. We're staying behind the knees at all times. Now, our right hand is gonna switch. Both hands will switch to heel grips and we'll start to turn them to the right. So here's where your partner can help you. Get your neck in a position you feel comfortable. Don't bend against the roll. And you know what I mean if you're upside down right now. Perfect. Also, don't sweat on their face.
Oh, God.
Poor Oogies. All right, now, when we go, guys, my right hand switching to the other leg. So you're gonna walk to the right, push their left foot down with your right hand, take your right hand off and switch to their right leg. Notice how I grip behind the back of her calf. From here, I'm gonna drop my left hand to the mat. My left knee's gonna hit and my right foot is gonna step on the back of her Achilles. If you have a smaller partner, don't step on the heel. Just slide your knee over the top of their hamstring. Now you're gonna slide your left leg through. Stay on your left side and extend your left leg. Now my right knee is staying pinching. It's gotta hold her femur down so my left leg can curl over it. If you're stepping on the heel, then it's relatively easy. You just stay stepping on the heel and your left foot will go right into the twister. Right leg will curl around your ankle, right shin to their shin, and we're ready to rock and roll. We are into the truck. I do banana split like we've learned, or I let go of the leg. I extend the lockdown. My right hand hooks the bicep. My left hand hooks the neck, and we're on to our back attack series. All right. So if you have a gi dummy, a lot of this is going to be practicing laying down and crisscrossing into the truck and then transitioning from there into your back attack series. So, thumbs up and maybe thumbs down if you have questions. How we feel? You guys feel good? No questions?
Can you run it one more time, Professor?
Yeah, of course, of course.
Like with us?
Let's see, this time I'm going to have Beth do it, but it's all the same, okay, guys? We can all watch together. Run this rep together again if you want, guys. First, double pants grips. Bottom player, feet to biceps. Top player, roll your hands underneath. Get those calf grips. Now from here, you're gonna start pushing the calves over the head and using your knees behind the hips, keeping them stacked up. Now you're gonna switch to your hands behind the heels and you're gonna keep them stacked, maybe even a little more, walk them to the right. Now, bottom player, you're gonna move your neck, keep yourself safe. Top player, don't lean so hard on your left hand, Jesus. Now, your right hand's gonna let go, and your right foot's gonna step on the heel. So you're gonna have to shuffle to the right a little bit to be able to reach. Now, your left hand's gonna hit the floor. Your left hip's gonna hit the floor. Stay stepping on the heel. Perfect. Now, remember, you gotta stay on your side to keep their hips up. Now, from here, you're gonna thread your lockdown, curl your figure four, and you're good to go. Hook the far leg, we're in the banana split, or they clear the leg and we move to the arm hook onto the back. Ah. All right, how's that feel? We feel good with it? You guys feel like trying it? Some of us already feeling like we're moving well? All right, let's clap it out, guys. No questions, we're going full steam on three. One, two, war time. Perfect. Remember, if you get stuck, Beth is right behind me. She's running the same technique. Now, with your stuffy buddy, the goal is going to be stepping on the imaginary leg, gripping the far leg, and laying down on your side, not your back. I really want to practice staying up on that hip so my bottom leg can kick through and thread as the twister hook. Find the lockdown, and then it doesn't really matter whether he has legs or not. I'm practicing the same thing we've been working on. Banana split, kick through, and chase the back. It's the exact same truck. We're just finding it from a new position. Perfect. Remember, shuffle to the right when you decide to go down. Give yourself an angle to where you can stay on your right hip. Thread your bottom hook, find the lockdown, connect to the legs, and you're ready for your banana split. Calf slice. Remember that the twister is going to be illegal in IBJJF. So you can practice it if you want, but the only specific tournaments will let you play that one. Just so you know. Nice. Very nice, Coach Nick. Nice, Wendy. There we go, Coach Alex. But we're going to need – I know it's tough. We're brand new, so we want to be careful here, right? I don't want to get her too smooshed up. We might want to practice some of our other passes from the warm-up if this doesn't feel great for her neck. You guys kind of decide for you, okay? But if she is going to try it, then we're going to need to get her just a little bit more stacked up to where her hips are off the floor. It's like you're going to help them do a back roll, guys. Their hips have got to point to the sky. They're going to be up on their shoulders. Perfect.
It's much easier with somebody your size.
Brayden, how you feel, buddy? Perfect. Perfect. Nice work, man. This is a great guard pass, guys. It seems really funny because we're going around the guard in kind of an odd way compared to our normal passing series. But I'm a big fan of this passing style, these lying leg drags, for our school training, you know, for your competitions. It's not something that's relatively going to use a lot in self-defense. You're not running into a lot of guards in self-defense. But in the school, and if you're a competitor, the guards have gotten pretty advanced now. And this is a very advanced way to approach this position from an upside-down perspective. Trying to fight how the human body works a little bit by getting behind those knees. Nice, John. Shuffle to the right. Yes, right foot's going to hold that leg down. Right hand's going to switch. We're going to lay on our left side. Thread that left foot through. Kick around the femur. Triangle your legs. Right foot behind your ankle. Perfect. Fall to our back and scoop upper leg for the truck. Very nice, John. Good work. From here, I can move to the back. Oh, you better finish with a choke, Blue Belt. Oh, tears, Blue Belt. Deep sadness. And time. Good work, my friends. Let's switch. Other person's turn. If you got a gi dummy, keep going. This is something that's going to take a lot of reps. Rep 100 is going to feel much, much smoother than rep 1, I promise. All right. Junior students, two pants grips on the knees. Senior students going to go feet to biceps. So you're going to roll your hands, palms under the calves. We're going to start pushing the calves towards the head. And as their legs get long, their hips will arc. And we're going to bring our knees behind those hips. From here, I'm going to switch my hands to the heels. I'm going to keep pushing their legs over their head, but I'm going to do it by walking to the right. Like I'm putting their foot toes to the ground. Now from here, my right foot or my right hand will switch to the top leg. My right foot is stepping on the heel. My left hand hits the ground. I slide to my left hip. My left foot kicks through. Remember, you got to stay on that left side for me so you can curl that left leg through and go triangle on their femur. Notice how I had to make an adjustment there because if it's too much on their knee, you won't be able to get the lockdown behind their leg. So use that foot on the heel, get them up, and then reattach to the triangle over the femur. Now the lockdown can attach. And here's my banana split. If I let go of the leg, our right hand will scoop the bicep. Our left hand will scoop the neck. We're on to the back. Go ahead and finish with a choke. Whew. Junior students, how you feel? Thumbs up, you feel good with that? No questions, youngins. You guys feel good?
How do you sit into the lockdown?
What was that, buddy?
How do you sit into the lockdown?
All right, perfect. We'll go through it together while everybody's drilling. You ready?
Okay.
All right, sweet. You get dad, and we'll get started. Everybody else, let's go on 3, 1, 2. Work time. No, we'll do it with that. All right, Josh and Jay, you guys ready? So first, we're going to get the double knee grips, and we're going to turn our hands under the calves. Perfect. Now with the calf grips, we're going to start pushing their feet over their head, and as their hips come up, we're going to bring our knees right behind their low back, keeping dad stacked. If he can, we'll put his feet on the floor, but we just got to be careful. Not everybody can. Now from here, we're going to shuffle to the right, both our hands on the heels. We're going to start pushing that hand, that foot in our right hand to the floor. Perfect. Now, from here, our left foot's going to step on that leg, usually right on the heel. Ooh, our right foot. Don't listen to me at all, buddy. Your right foot. Now, from here, your right hand switches to the top leg, and your left hand posts on the floor. We're trying to keep them hips to the sky, right? So let's get Josh, let's get dad's hips up a little bit. Sorry, guys. I'm having a hard time. The lights are a little dark. It looks like I may need to get dad up. Hey, there we go. Yeah, not bad here, not bad. Now, from here, we're gonna put our right hand on the mat. Perfect. And now you're gonna slide onto your right side, your right knee, right underneath dad's leg. Perfect. Now your right foot's gonna curl over dad's femur. Yep, and now if you're already on the back, you take it. But a lot of times, dad will stay with his back on the mat, his feet in the air.
Perfect, because he doesn't want to give up his back, and that's why we'll triangle our left leg around our right ankle. Nice. Yes. Yeah, you feel it. And now we've made the truck. Very nice, my friend. Good work. Nice job. Coach, how you feel? Coach Andrew, how you feel, buddy?
Oh, I'm good. I was just watching to see how Beth grabbed the upper leg as she slid underneath. That's all.
Oh, yeah, that's a great cue. That right hand has that cross grip like their ankle on the back of our wrist.
Yes, sir.
So I want to be able to push it away, keep it long, so I keep those hips nice and high.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Quick question for you, Professor.
Yeah, man.
So with the knee that you're finally sliding underneath to get that underhook, go under and get the figure four. When you go into that, are you keeping that like super tight the whole time and just forcing it down underneath their back and butt, or do you like come out and then slide it back down?
I think that will depend on how the movement is feeling during the actual go, right? So if they're trying to really wiggle a lot, especially the smaller weight classes, you'll see the youngins do this technique, like the smaller color belts, man, they'll fly into that truck entry, right? Just jam the knee through. Other times, it's just way more methodical. And you're going to keep that knee super tight, inch by inch, find your way through the leg, because that person's giving you like that grind style defense. They're not exploding away, but they're not giving up anything very fast either, right? So sometimes it's going to take two different approaches there at times, for sure.
Thank you, Professor.
Nice, Coach E. Find our lockdown. Puts us in the truck. Perfect. Very nice, Emily. Now, we're going to stay stepping on his heel because we'd like to keep that leg long. Yeah, it's going to help us keep his hips up. So when you lay down on your left side, we're going to try to keep Thomas's knee over his face. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Keep pushing that right hand towards Thomas. Yes. And now your left leg's going to slide through. And you're going to curl that left leg around Thomas's femur. There we go. Because we're going to triangle our right foot or our right leg over that left leg. Now, let's be careful here. Let's make sure we're above his knee relative to his hip, right? We want to slide up so we don't hurt his leg with the lockdown. Now, that right foot is going to curl and get behind Thomas's heel. Very nice. Now, I got to be really careful here because you got mad pressure on his leg. We're going to take our hands and cup them around his free leg, the one that's right in front of your arms. Yes, one arm over the shin, one arm around the thigh, grab our fingers together. Now, if you wanted to, we'd have to go really slow here, but if you pull your hands to your face while extending your leg, we're gonna banana split, a very, very tight inner thigh stretch. Perfect. Thomas won't like that. He'll try to kick his right leg out, and that's how we'll get to his back. Yes, you did great, Emily. Nice job, very nice. You are doing fantastic, my friend. Whew. Finish up this rep, guys. 30 seconds. Probably get two reps, maybe. All about that stack. Get them up. Get them up.
Professor, I have to run. I have to work at 7, but thank you so much.
Wendy, thank you so much for training. Great work tonight.
Thanks. Hi, Beth. Thank you, Beth. That was really interesting.
Good work, my friend.
Yeah, thank you. I'll see you next time.
And nice. Very nice, Lamberts. Yes. Good work, Ethan. Very nice. Quan, we'll get you piece it all together, bro. Very nice. And time, guys. Good work. We'll thank our partners, fix our geese, line it up. Whew. As always, huge thank yous to Elizabeth, the Purple Belt Huddleston. Fantastic Uki. You guys see, she knocks out a ton of reps. Super, super helpful. I hope you're using that as a resource, guys. Man, I appreciate everybody coming in tonight. Like we talked about,
the things that we've been able to get into are strictly because of your consistency. Like your willingness to stay grinding on this is allowing you to pick up some pretty deep skill sets. Like these are not things that you would ever know unless you're like a true jiu-jitsu fighter. So I'm super impressed with everybody that's been coming through. It's a lot of fun for me to get to dive into techniques like this. It's all going to start tying together soon. Hopefully it's already starting to feel like that, how that twister hook and the truck are kind of available. They're tied to how you're passing. And now we're starting to see how our passes are all tied together. I'm really excited for when we get back into the schools. And like we talked about, guys, there's multiple plans at play. We're working on them constantly to find a way to get back on the mats in some capacity as quickly as possible. And when we do, I'm very excited to hear from all of you guys about how this feels against the resisting opponents, right? Like, I would love to hear about how different your game is going to feel for you with these new skills you've added in compared to when we left off, right? Don't get hurt. You got to go slow and first come back. But I'm really excited for you to notice the difference. And right now it's kind of hard to notice because you're in the grind. You're the one doing all the work. But when we get back into trainings, you're going to have some reference points from people you know their game, what it feels like. You're going to be able to really tell the benefit to your hard work through this really tough time. And I'm excited about that for all you guys. That's awesome. I'm really stoked that you took this time and used it. It's been super beneficial towards your jiu-jitsu and a lot of different ways that you'll notice as soon as we're back in the school. Guys, thank you so much. Thank you to our Uki. We'll bow out. Whew.